Let's talk about what it takes to deploy Amazon Web Service infrastructure using Terraform. Here we go! First step is we're going to need some credentials. Go to your AWS portal and click on your username in the upper right-hand corner. From that drop-down, select Security Credentials. There are certainly other ways to authenticate, especially if you're running Terraform in an EC2 instance already in the cloud. But for this demonstration, we're going to be running from a local machine. So on our security page here, we're going to create an access key. And here is where you can copy these two values. I'm going to show you where we're going to put them down at our command line. So there's one of two ways you could go with this using your access and your secret key. You can create environment variables like I'm showing you there at the bottom, or inside of your AWS hidden directory in your home directory, open a file called credentials. Give this group a name. I'm just going to call it dev for demonstration purposes. So for later, remember, this is where the word dev came from. We're going to keep this build fairly basic, but giving you everything you need to know to be able to build an AWS deployment of any size. And as you can see here, we have three different TF files. And it's purely best practices that we've got these files named and arranged the way that they are. In Terraform, you could bang every single block of your code into one file, and the only people who would suffer would be your coworkers who have to read it. But Terraform doesn't care. But let's start breaking our way through these so we can understand what we're going to build and how we got to where we got. This is a variable TF file, and it's where we're going to keep all the variables we may want to define that changes the way that our Terraform module runs. We're going to keep things simple. And to start, there's an example of a variable block with a lot of all the different things that you can do with it. The one variable that we are going to set is what region is that we are going to be building our infrastructure. By default, US West 2, but that can absolutely be changed. And here we are inside of our actual main.tf file. There's two different blocks that you're seeing here, and this first block is the Terraform block. There's only ever going to be one of these, and this is where we are telling Terraform, all right, what tools are we going to use in order to build our AWS infrastructure? We're going to be using the AWS provider, which is written by HashiCorp. And these version numbers you're seeing here are what version of this provider do we want to use, and what version of Terraform itself are we going to want to use. But let's follow that up with a website that you really ought to have bookmarked if you're going to work with Terraform, the Terraform Registry. If we search for AWS, there's the provider that we're talking about. And if we click on documentation, you can see down the left-hand side, these are all of the documentations for all of the different types of resources and data blocks that we'll be making inside of this module. We'll be referring back to this as we go through. If we call on your powers of memorization for a sec, do you recognize these? var.region. Well, we had a variable block called region. Yep, that's exactly what's happening here. When we are telling the AWS provider what we want it to do, including what region we want it to build in our infrastructure, that may change from build to build. So having a variable like this can make it very easy to swap that out, because chances are you may have to set one value in multiple places. Also, profile dev. Do you remember when we were talking about authentication? And our AWS credentials, we put our credentials inside of a profile called dev. So we're going to be using that access and secret key for what we're going to build. So what are we going to build? Well, you can see from this display, but if it's your first time working with Terraform, let's explain what we're looking at. Blocks are always labeled by their type as the very first word. So these three resource blocks are pieces of infrastructure that we are going to build. The ultimate goal is that we're going to fire up an instance. But what we want to be able to do is to be able to SSH into that instance. So we are going to be adding an AWS key pair that we're going to upload from our local machine. What we've also got is a security group that we're going to tie to this AWS instance. Now, each and every one of these resources, AWS key pair, AWS instance, AWS security group, can be found if we were to copy that and go back to our Terraform registry AWS documentation. If we search for AWS instance over here on the left, then there will be several different matches. I use Control F to really quick look through that because there are tons of resources. Ah, there we go. EC2 resources AWS instance. This will provide an EC2 instance resource. So on this page, this is where you can find examples that can be copied and pasted and ready to go. And what you're also going to find is that all of the parameters, so that is these key value pairs that you see indented underneath any block, those all have meaning, and you can find exactly what those mean in the documentation just by scrolling down and searching for it. I'll be explaining what they mean as we go through our example here. Something that makes Terraform so slick and quick and easily updatable to run is also one of the things that makes it very overwhelming for people that are new to Terraform. If we take a look at this, very few of these parameters are very straightforward. Instance type is T2 micro. So we're going to be using free tier items. So even if you have a free tier account, you'll be able to run this particular demonstration in your environment. But for others like AMI, we can see that that's anything but specific. data.aws.ami.ubuntu.id. What? Okay. You'll notice that there is indeed a block called data up here that it is AWS AMI. And we also see that it is named Ubuntu. Data blocks do not build resources. What they do is they fetch information. What we're going to use to describe what machine image goes inside of this particular instance is coming from this data block. If we take a look inside, here's what's going on. Because AMI values, which are strings that represent, yes, I want an Ubuntu machine with such and such a spec, can differ from region to region. And the last thing the automators want to do is constantly be fetching new information. They just want their automation to work no matter where you are. This AWS AMI data block is going to find the most recent image that matches the following filters. So basically, we're looking for what is an Ubuntu, like AMD 64 server that we could use to run inside of an instance. It's going to find that information for us. So here, data.aws.ami.ubuntu is referring to this block. What this last field right here is, ID, is returning an attribute, basically a piece of data that is being returned from the data block. So what's the ID of that AMI? We'll pull that out automatically, and we will assign it to this field inside of our resource block. Now, in the very next line, we've got something else that is referring to a separate block. AWS key pair dot deployer is referring to this resource right here. So if this resource, AWS instance, is building an instance, what this resource represents is a key pair that is being uploaded from our local machine into our AWS instance. So if we were to open this up, pretty simple, we're giving the key an arbitrary name. This is an example of a Terraform function. What file is going to do is that it is going to find on my local machine this file, SSH key pub. And this will make sure that this gets uploaded. So when we see deployer.keyname, what's happening there is that we're saying, hey, from that resource block, what's the name of the key? So you'll often see resource blocks and data blocks referring each other because building infrastructure means having a lot of interconnected parts. The last things of significance that I'll point out is that we're just going to run an Apache server inside of this instance when it's up and running. And also, we're going to tag our instance with this name. But once again, we've got another line that is referring to another block, AWS Security Group .sg underscore SSH is referring to our last resource block inside of our main.tf file. So if we crack that open and we take a look inside, here we're giving our security group a name, totally arbitrary, call it what you want. And we are providing what the ingress and the egress rules are that we want this security group to have. We are going to attach the security group to our instance. So therefore, our instance is going to inherit these rules. And so with that said, what will wind up happening is that from this security group, we will pull its ID value, which is something we otherwise would have had to have manually typed in when asking, hey, what's the security group ID for the instance that we're trying to fire up? All right, so we're almost there. There's one last file for us to take a look at. Output blocks can have some really useful functionality in more sophisticated Terraform modules. For this, we're going to be using it for one purpose. Think of it as like a debug or like a printing feature if this were a piece of code. Because what each one of these outputs is going to do is that it is going to print out some information for us after our entire infrastructure is built. So here we're pulling out what's the ID of the instance that we're going to build. What is the IP address of the web server when it comes online? And what will be the ID of the security group that we wind up building? And that's it for reviewing our files. Let's start building. Here's a cool look under the hood. Terraform init is the first command you need to run before you can do any other Terraform commands. And pro tip, always build your Terraform modules inside of brand spanking new directories, no hidden files or anything. If we run Terraform init here, what you're going to see suddenly appearing up inside of that tree is our HashiCorp AWS provider, the one that we said we wanted to use to build our project. Well, this is the way that Terraform works. It downloads all the code that is required in order for your infrastructure to be built. But now that that's run, let's put together a plan. It's always best practice to use Terraform plan, because what this is going to do is that it's going to take a look at Terraform thinking, okay, what have I already built for this user and what are they asking me to build? And basically it'll say, what do I need to do to get from point A to point B? What you're seeing inside of this display is that there are three different things that we need to add. And here you can review all of the different parameters for all of the different things we're going to build. Like what are the ingress and egress rules for our security group? What is the key pair that we uploaded? I already built that off camera. And here you can also see everything for what we're going to build for our AWS instance and what we're going to build for our AWS instance. And do you see how the AMI value is now actually a string? Our data block went and found that information for us so that we didn't have to. Pretty convenient. So, assuming that everything here is looking good and that we are ready to pull the trigger on this, then we'll say Terraform apply. This is going to give us the exact same output again. You should not see anything different when you run this. However, this time it is going to prompt us, do you want to perform these actions? The answer to that question, of course, is yes. Now, this will take a minute, but let it run. If you get any errors, like this one, make sure that you read them and understand what exactly the issue is. Looks like I've already got a key pair already up that has that name. Okay, this can be fixed by hopping inside of main.tf. I could have deleted that key pair, but instead, we'll just call this something else. Developer key alt-3 demo should do the trick. And then just Terraform apply it again. The good news is that it's just as easy to tear down the infrastructure that you build as it is to set it up using Terraform. So don't be too afraid with failure, especially because these are free resources that we're building, and these will cost you pennies, if anything, to actually build. See you on the other end of this. All right, mission complete. And as you can see down there in our outputs, remember how we said these are all the different things that I would like to know after it's built, such as the public IP address, the ID of the instance, and the security group ID can all be printed out after the fact extremely easily, making that information much more accessible. Of course, this is just scratching the surface, the cool stuff that you can do with Terraform, with AWS and other clouds, which we can and will define inside of future videos. But if it's Terraform itself that you need more practice with, no matter what the platform, check us out at Alta3 Academy, where you'll be given labs, videos featuring this guy, as well as an actual environment, which no other training company does, all of which you can find from the link down inside of the description. Happy terraforming, everybody!